Welcome to Think Big with Dan and Kasim. Join hosts Dan Melnick and Kasim Masood as they explore big ideas, limitless possibilities, and engage with visionaries, entrepreneurs, and thought leaders who dare to dream big. Get inspired, motivated, and find practical tips for personal growth. Think big, dream bigger, and ignite your potential.
Welcome to the Think Big with Dan and Kasim. Today, our guest is Casey Melvin. Casey, how are you? Let us know what you do and where you live.
Hi, Kasim. Thanks so much for having me on the podcast today. My name is Casey Melvin. I'm the co-founder and CEO of The Future of Jewelry. We're an on-demand custom jewelry platform that allows every customer to design their own signet ring in jewelry in 3D and see it in real time. We've developed a whole 3D platform where the customer can go visit, design their ring. We've built several different apps on top of that. So we have a ring size app that can generate over 155 different ring sizes in the normal ring span. And we also have a pricing algorithm that takes into account the spot price of metal on that day and does a live volume calculation while calculating the price. So we're an on-demand custom jewelry platform.
All right, that's awesome. So how this idea came into the existence, from where this story starts?
Yeah, so it started back actually in 2016, and I was in law school. Both my sister and I were in law school. We never had plans to do any sort of startup or anything like that. But we came across a void in the market that we thought that we could do better with technology. So back in 2016, we just finished our first year of law school. We had a great opportunity to study abroad at the University of Oxford. We were studying comparative law there for the summer. And it was back in 2016, and the EasyJet fares were really, really low, and we were trying to take advantage of that summer because we had never really traveled to Europe before. So we took the cheapest flight we could find every weekend, and we were exploring Europe together. And we wanted to buy a memento, like something to mark the summer together, because we were having like such a great time. And we happened into this small Spanish jewelry store the one day. And the owner of the store was there, and he was showing us around the cases and being really generous. And we came across a plain gold signet ring. And as I said, we were both planning to be lawyers, so we weren't, you know, really, we weren't going to invest in some like obnoxious piece of jewelry. We wanted kind of like standard pieces that we could wear with everything, you know, in our professional capacity. So we came across these plain gold signet rings, and my sister was like, oh, wouldn't that be cool if we could both get our signet ring and with our initials hand etched on the front. So the owner had taken the ring out of the case, and it fit me, but it didn't fit my sister. My sister has a really like small ring size that they don't usually carry going to shop for jewelry or shop for rings specifically. So we said, you know what, I bet you we're going to be able to find something online that's similar and in the same price range when we get home, and we'll still have this, you know, memento together. We'll remember this experience that we had. So, you know, fast forward to, we're back in Ohio, back in law school, we're back from Oxford. And we started doing a lot of research into trying to find a ring for my sister. And we really couldn't find anything that would meet our needs. So in precious metal, we wanted something quality. We wanted something in the you know, $300-$400 price range. Mm-hmm. And we wanted it in something in her rare size and customizable. And when we were doing all the research, we either found, you know, a $2,800, $3,000 ring from Tiffany's that you had to pay extra to get the size modified and to add the customization. Or we found something, you know, closer, you know, a base metal ring that would probably turn your hand green and was not in my sister's size. So we started seeing a lot of, you know, jewelry is one of the oldest businesses on the planet. You know, it's one of the oldest industries. And their websites weren't really, you know, up to the technological standards, let's say, as some of the other ones at that time back in 2017. So we thought that we could try to build something that would allow for on-demand customization and, you know, reach a broader range of people, because a lot of people are used to, you know, going to the mall on buying something, buying a piece of jewelry out of the case, and hopefully it's your size, or maybe you have to pay extra to get it modified. So that was really the idea behind the company, was this, you know, serving people, serving rare ring sizes and allowing for on-demand customization, where, you know, custom jewelry has been made the same way for thousands of years, until the Industrial Revolution and machine-made products. You know, every piece used to be custom. The ring sizes we know today really serve mass production. So we wanted to do something that would allow a broader range of sizes and build something on top of that.
All right, that's great. So let us know how you can customize your jewelry. If you can share your screen and let us know.
Yes, sure. So we've been doing this for some time now. We've spent a lot of time building out our platform. So when we first started the company, the advice really was, you know, have an iPhone app and have an Android app, and you have to maintain both of those. And we did start on that route, but we ran into some problems where there would be, you know, there would be a lot of issues having the syncing between the apps and the backends, and it was just kind of a headache. So we kind of started over in 2019, and we said, let's build a web-based 3D platform. So this is our platform. This is our website. You go right on thefutureofjewelry.com, and it's super fast. It works on your phone, works on your laptop, but you can basically select your ring, and in 3D, we have several different shapes you can select from and see it in real time. And you can, you know, select from your shape. We also have different band styles that you can select from. So I'll do a custom band. And we have the materials that we have are solid sterling silver, so a silver alloy that is tarnish resistant. And then we have 14 karat rose gold, white gold, and yellow gold. And as I said, we have a pricing algorithm built in so that every piece of jewelry is, the volume is calculated, and then the pricing algorithm is tagged to the spot price of metal on that day. So we're really making the same on every single ring, and it's calculated live time. Another really cool feature that we have is that we can do over 155 different ring sizes. And as you see, if I move down to a size 3, the price is going to reflect that smaller size because it's smaller of a volume. But we can do down to the millimeter for your ring size. So we have a lot more flexibility than most ring companies. And you can see it right in 3D. And one of my favorite ways to customize a ring is adding your signature, because what other way to do something custom than something AI can't do, your own handwriting. So I'll show you right here. I'll add my signature, and you just press apply on ring, and you can see that in real time.
Nice.
You also can have it engraved and, you know, add to cart. So there's a lot of different ways you can customize. We build a lot of different apps on top of that, but that's kind of what we built after we encountered the pain points that we had.
Mm-hmm. Completely makes sense. And how does try it on feature work?
What's that?
Try it on. There's a button, try it on.
Oh yeah, on the try it on. So that you can see it actually on a hand. If you wanted to see how it would look, you know, on your hand or in a different metal. And you can see that in real time. And another cool feature that we added, so we incorporate 3D printing into our manufacturing process. We 3D print into a high definition wax resin, and then, you know, using an investment casting method that's thousands of years old. During the pandemic, we added this print it yourself option. So for $5, you can actually customize your ring, and we'll instantly email you the file, and you can 3D print it yourself. So that kind of serves the 3D printing community as well. We also do precious metal rings. So we have both options to serve everybody.
All right. Awesome. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay. So let us know, like, what are your future goals? Maybe in terms of next 3 to 6 months.
So the next 3 to 6 months, we have a couple of different product launches coming. So where we started with signet rings, we're now expanding into pendants and wedding bands. Those have a slightly different interface, because for the wedding bands, for the two partners, you can have each partner customize the inside of the other person's wedding band. So that was a feature that we incorporated into that app. And then we also have pendants, which are really fun. We added borders and different bales that you can add. And we still have all the features that you can, you know, add your signature, you can upload a logo or your artwork, you can upload a 3D file. I mean, we have tons of apps. Really, it's infinite how all the possibilities that there are. So we have two big product launches. In the next 6 months, we're working on our Phidias app. That's what we call the software that we're going to be launching in a B2B context. context to allow other companies to incorporate our 3D visualization and in the different capabilities that we built with our platform.
Completely makes sense. So what is the biggest challenge you're facing at this time?
I would say the biggest challenge is matching our scalability to our manufacturing ability. So we have several partners that we work with in the United States to fulfill our United States orders. And so as we scale our marketing plan, we're trying to make sure that we're able to take in those that influx of orders, because right now we're turning around a ring from when you click checkout, you'll have it delivered within 3 weeks. We're always trying to make that time smaller, that time to delivery. We're trying to definitely shorten our supply chain up, but definitely it's matching up our supply side and our manufacturing side.
All right, really makes sense. So how you get a customer, like what are your ways for the marketing, and how you get a customer, like you get a customer from online, from the offline space? So how are you getting customers?
So we do a lot of conferences and demonstrations for anywhere from like students to, people in the 3D printing community to, jewelry conferences. So we're always getting our in-person events actually get us we see a lot of sales from that. But we're also expanding into, our TikTok and Instagram reaching out, because there's so many ways that you can custom do a really fun thing with this jewelry that we're doing, for people with in between sizes, or people that have been underserved by the current jewelry ring sizing market, to, wedding monograms that you paid a lot to have an artist create. You can upload that right onto our website and, make a ring. We're basically trying to find the little niche markets and serve, different inspiration and different content to them to get the sales.
Completely makes sense. So how do you differentiate your business from the others in the market? I'm not sure even if you have any competitors or not, but yeah, if you have, then how?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we're definitely not the only custom jewelry company, and we're definitely not the only jewelry company that incorporates 3D printing. But the thing that makes us different and differentiates us is our platform, our robust software. We've spent a lot of time, going from 2D to 3D is a very difficult thing to do, and making sure that everything that looks on the screen is represented by how this final product will look. We want to make sure that the base models are printable. There's all different things that you can encounter into that, but we've really done the legwork and to make sure that this goes off without a hitch. And so that's the thing that I'm most proud of is the software. And that's what differentiates us. Because if you think about it, people are used to going into a mall or a jewelry store and hoping there's something that will suit them. This is really, flipping the script on that and making the customer part of the design process. And for thousands of years, artisans that had that specialized skill, they're out of the price range, out of the affordability for most people. So we really wanted to take out and kind of automate that expensive element, bring it into the customer's hands, and then, pass on the savings to them.
Okay, so this thing is playing an essential part to reduce the cost for the customers, right?
Yeah, absolutely. At a more accessible price, because we're automating that part. And, there's always going to be jewelers that serve the crown, or that, that make, really specialized jewelry. There's always going to be those top artisans. But for the masses, it was out of the realm of possibility. So we're trying to just, expand that universe and allow custom jewelry to be, more accessible, affordable, and in your proper size.
All right. So I'm a bit curious, like how you define your audience. Like everybody who is looking for a custom jewelry is your customer, or there are some other parameters as well?
I would say young people that are maybe out of college and they want pieces that will last a lifetime, because as millennials and Gen Z are very conscious of, sustainability and the ramifications of the manufacturing process. So our customer is someone who cares about those things, and also doesn't have a ton of money to spend, but maybe has some income that they want to spend on a good piece that they'll be able to use in their professional careers.
All right. So how do you deliver the products? How you use the courier services? I'm not sure, because these products are expensive. So how you make sure the whole process?
So they are expensive, but they are solid precious metal. So you'll see that there's some fashion jewelry that's, priced way above where we are because you might be paying for the brand or, someone that was wearing it, will make the price really skyrocket. So where we are is, yeah, it's an investment, but these are heirloom pieces of jewelry that will last the test of time and they won't go out of style. These are pieces that will, they're an investment, but they are solid. They're precious metal. They're heirloom. They're one of a kind. So that's what makes it really special.
All right. So let us know if you can give us a biggest piece of advice to whoever is watching this podcast.
If I would give a piece of advice to especially startup or business owners is to really get a good circle around a good kitchen cabinet of people around you that can give you good advice and give you feedback because it's obviously very stressful running a startup and there's a lot of unknowns. But and sometimes you can get into your own head, or sometimes, people can kind of lead you down the wrong path. And you have to really, I think, be honest with yourself and keep people around you that are going to keep you humble and that are going to give you feedback.
All right. So yeah, I liked your idea, like the whole process of going from idea to the execution side. That was inspirational, and I believe this will be good insights for the ones who are going to start new businesses or they have started their new businesses and they are fresh entrepreneurs. So that's cool, Casey. I really liked the conversation with you today. It was fruitful. So let us know if you can give us your website address and you can like share your social media handles, wherever people can reach you, wherever it is convenient for you.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're on social media. We're at The Future of Jewelry on TikTok, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube. And our website is thefutureofjewelry.com. Or if you have some problems spelling jewelry, we also own tfoj.com. So a four letter, tfoj.com. And that'll take you to our custom signet ring customizer. And the wedding band app and the pendant apps are going to be up in the next couple of weeks. So you can keep checking back for that.
That's exciting. That's exciting indeed. So, thanks, Casey. Thanks for joining us today. It was a pleasure to talk to you. Have a good day.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me. I really appreciate it.
Thanks, Casey. Bye.
Bye.